Hi everyone, Grant Kay here for the Flame Premium Learning Channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at the VFX Shot Publish Workflow introduced in Flame Premium 2015 Extension 2. The purpose of this workflow is to be able to create a centralized shot distribution system in a VFX pipeline. This means artists using Flame, Flare, and Flame Assist can iterate and version their work, and all of this will be automatically updated in the master timeline. So this workflow promotes a collaborative working environment using a centralized storage. This can work between multiple Flame products and potentially other third-party products. So how have we made this possible? Well, there are a few underlying points that need to be mentioned in order to use this workflow. Firstly, every system involved in the workflow must have an identical path to the media. This is regardless of which Flame product you are using. For example, if your media is located on a SAN, the file path might be /SAN/volume/project/media. So each machine must have the same identical mount point so that any setups loaded will simply use the same file path to connect to the media. Secondly, there is going to be a lot of talk about open clips. Open clips are small metadata XML files that reference the media used in the Flame products. The XML files will point to the original media as well as any new version renders that are created. This will make it possible to have new versions of VFX shots appear in the sequence as soon as they become available. The third and final point for now is that by using this workflow, all media and clip metadata is unmanaged. By that, I mean media, clip metadata, and setups reside in a central location, and the Flame products are simply reading and writing to these locations. So external tools will be required to archive and delete unused media. This is in contrast to normally letting Flame manage media and metadata. For example, if the data is not used, it automatically gets removed from the Flame's managed database. So this is a big change for experienced artists who are used to Flame managing everything in its database. For most jobs, you can still work the old way, but the VFX Shot Publish workflow gives you a different collaborative pipeline compared to shared libraries, wiring, and etc. Not everyone will use this workflow, and you might only use it for certain jobs, whether you're in a large facility or one-man company. Now there are a few workflow steps to prepare for the VFX Shot Publish. Normally, in most VFX shot distribution scenarios, each shot will be labeled in a certain way to identify each shot for VFX work. This is different to the naming conventions that would be used during editorial. For example, I've conformed a sequence that could be edited by a third-party application or directly in Flame. The initial naming on each segment comes from the editorial context, and in most cases, it could be preserved to track segments or used in other editorial tasks. In VFX pipelines, the segment or layered group of segments would normally be given a logical naming convention to track VFX work. So now you have the ability to assign shot names to single segments or a layered group of segments to be used in various VFX shots. The bottom track in the sequence contains the main body of the edit, so we'll assign the shot names to all the segments in this track. Select the bottom track. Right-click or meta-click for the contextual menu. The rename option renamed the segment's original name that identifies each individual segment in the editorial structure I mentioned earlier. The rename shot option allows you to add secondary VFX shot names to each segment or a group of segments for VFX distribution. When you select the option, the renaming window appears that gives you the ability to name one or multiple selections of shots. An additional point to note is that the renaming window gives you a series of tokens which allows you to rename your segments based on certain sets of criteria. For example, you would start aligning the shot name grouping to your pipeline's naming convention. So you would call each segment shot. Now, using the token system, you could give each shot in the sequence a number based on their order or index in the sequence. The default padding is set to 3 zeros. A good tip is that you can change the padding by adding hash symbols within the token syntax. The general idea is that you can customize this to match what your facility may be using or set up a brand new pipeline. As an optional step, I'll add another zero after the token. Shot 1 is 10, shot 2 is 20, and so on. So if any edits are done to the sequence, the segment naming would still be in a sequential order. I'll confirm the shot naming for the base layer and move around the sequence. So each shot is sequentially numbered to my requirements. As for any VFX shots that require images from the above layers, the additional layers need to list under the same shot name in order to ensure they are correctly distributed to the appropriate VFX shot directory. Currently, you have to do this one at a time per layer stack. Hold Ctrl and multi-select all the layers in the stack. Call up the contextual menu and choose Rename Shot. You won't need any tokens this time. All you need to do is type the shot name from the base segment into the text editor. When you press Enter, all the shots in the stack will have the same VFX shot name or grouping. I'll scroll over to the second set of layers and perform the same operations to assign the matching VFX shot name to all the layers. Now, this is not mandatory, but in some cases, it is also handy to use the track naming so you can identify images by their particular track. This is easily achievable if you expand the track names and call up the contextual menu to access the renaming commands. Once again, you can customize the naming to your particular pipeline. So for example, I'll select all the segments in the sequence and choose Rename. You will get the same text box as the Rename Shot option. The first part of the segment name will be based on the shot name. I'll add an underscore and open the token pull down again. The second token will be based on track name. Remember to click Enter to continue. So each segment will eventually be distributed to their relevant shot location. Any layered elements will also be placed in the matching shot name directory. And finally, all the new file names will be based on the name of the segments. This will ensure that you and other team members will have a defined naming and directory convention for distributed centralized VFX work. The renaming workflow is much faster compared to previous versions of Flame Premium, and this will definitely complement a variety of editorial and VFX workflows. In the next video, we'll go through the sequence publish process to distribute the media out to a centralized location. You'll also see the new publish timeline that now tracks the open clips as part of the workflow. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Premium Learning Channel for future videos.